So I just bought the materials for my assembly table. Very cheap. As you can see, it was $125 with a Monster Energy drink. That is just for the 2x4s and the plywood. That is not including the pocket holes that I already have at the house. So let me get home and put this thing together.
So this workbench slash assembly table is going to be made with minimal tools and minimal materials. I will have plans available on my website linked down below, and also additional add-ons coming soon, so keep an eye out on that.
Okay, so we got the legs cut. We're going to actually piece them together like in an L shape just to give it a little bit more support. What we're going to use to attach all this together is pocket holes. So now we're going to turn them into the L shape, and with using 2x4s, you need to have the 2.5-inch pocket screws. So we are going to find the good sides. Obviously, we're going to try to keep the labels and stuff hidden. Use these brand new ones I just bought. They are not the best, but for like $2.50 at Harbor Freight, you really can't beat that. Let's make sure the edges are lined up. Now I'll take the clamps off since they are screwed together. I mean, you could use glue in this, but in case I ever decide to take this apart and make a different one, I can always salvage the lumber. So yeah, it's not as flush because I haven't planed it or anything, but I mean, it's just an assembly table. So that's what we're looking for right there. Okay, now that all the legs are put together, I think we're gonna orient the long side on the long part of the table. So just as a quick and easy look, it's gonna be about like that. So I got to do the pocket holes and the stretchers on the top for the long side. And I know not everyone's like this. I was not for 5 years until I built this shop. But man, is it nice to have tall ceilings. So since this is so much space so I can't actually clamp it, what I'm going to do is take a 2x4 so I can figure out where it needs to be. And now it's flush, and I'll do the same thing the other side, and then I can rest it on there while I screw it in. This table is gonna be massive, but now I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put the screws in there, put one hand on this side and press real tight, and then drive them in. Set the other one on top and then clamp it all around the side and put some weight in the middle and let it sit overnight. and hopefully it glues up flat. The table, I've leveled it out for the most part, it's pretty good. So I got it glued up, the two pieces of 3/4 plywood, clamped it all the way around the edge so the sides are at least clamped real good, and then put some weight in the middle. So, we'll wait on that till tomorrow and see how it is. Just the parts that are gonna overlap the 2x4 frame, because right now there's not really a point of drilling holes in that section, simply because that section's gonna line up on this. So I need to find where I wanna put the holes in between that. So that's why I went ahead and marked this out so I would not do that. So now I'm gonna lay out the holes, drill all the holes, and attach it. I'm gonna use a spade bit, or speed bit, or whatever you wanna call it, just simply because it's faster. It doesn't make as clean a hole as a Forstner bit, but I'm trying to do this fast, and the Forstner bit through the half inch or inch and a half material is gonna take longer than I want it to. So we're just gonna speed through this real quick and knock it out. Put these blocks the same distance from the top to the bottom as this. So now I'm going to rest it on the side and then come from the inside with some screws. So when you make this table yourself on the top pieces, definitely go ahead and put pocket screws in. Or pocket holes so you can attach the top. Since I didn't do that, I'm now gonna add it. It's not really any big deal. It's a little different now. I have to get up under it, I guess, to do it, but no problem. So didn't do that I do recommend before attaching the top, go ahead and put a couple pocket holes in the three middle pieces, just because that makes it easier. I did take the pocket screw and screw it in at an angle to attach it, so it's held down anyways, but it'd be easier if you went ahead and did the pockets beforehand. Just gotta do the holes. I think I'm only gonna do the holes halfway. You can only do about from there to here. So this end is where I hold everything down, and that end's where I do whatever else. I have this one clamped in here. But I'll show you, I mean, it can move a little bit, but for the most part, it's in there good. Probably need to get maybe one or two more of these. Normally, I would have the other one here, but since I was just taking the thumbnail, I did it this way. And once two of them are clamped,
you pretty much can't even move this thing.
I only put dog holes again on half because I didn't really think it needed to be all over the place, so I can secure it here and secure pieces down here. Probably would get another couple clamps just so, I mean, one does it good, but two, it wouldn't be able to twist at all. Same thing with this. But I will have plans available, link down below for this. Again, it was pretty minimal materials, and I'll have all that listed down below. If you like this video, please click that thumbs up button. Also, subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. I know I haven't posted a lot of videos lately. I have a bunch of projects I'm working on for people, cabinet builds, and I'll have actually a lot of jigs that I've made while building this that I'll show videos that are very, there was a bug, that are very short and very cheap and easy to make. So until then, I'll see y'all next time.